thanks for joining me today for the reveal of our Picket Fence Studio Stamptember 2021 collaboration stamp set. This adorable set is called Sarcastic Kitties. As with all of our Simon Says Stamp Stamptember exclusive collaboration sets, this set is only available while supplies last. So if you love it, you're definitely going to want to grab it while you can. We have the option of being able to purchase the stamp and die set together, or you can purchase just the stamps alone. It's your choice. So I have links to the set down below in the video description if you'd like to go ahead and purchase one. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I made a scene using these kitties. I have cats. I'm a huge cat person, and I wanted to create a card that showcased these kitties in a way that they look like my cats. I'm also going to be pairing this Sarcastic Kitties stamp set, which is super cute. I'm going to be pairing it with some other Simon Says stamp products, one of which is the Front Porch Family set. Now, the other Simon Says stamp products that I'm going to be using today, the Front Porch Family set and also a Tumbling Leaves stencil, those two products are not exclusive to Stamptember. They are sets that you can purchase at any time. The only limited edition collaboration exclusive is this Picket Fence Sarcastic Kitty set. So from the stamp set, I'm going to be using two of the kitties, plus then one of the people images from the Front Porch Family set and a couple of the pumpkins and the succulent. So for my card today, I'm going to be doing some watercoloring. So in order to do that, I need to stamp my images with a waterproof ink, which I've chosen some Simon Says Stamp Barely Beige ink for this. I'm going to ink up the images and then stamp them down twice so I get a really nice dark impression. Because I am stamping onto watercolor paper, it's textured, and so stamping can be a little bit difficult on watercolor paper. So I wanted to make sure I got a crisp, clean impression, so that's why I stamped twice. All right, so now we're gonna do the watercoloring. I'm using Karen markers to do the coloring today. I love their vibrancy and how easy they are to blend. If you notice, as I'm coloring these images, any of the lines of the stamped image look darker than the actual coloring inside the lines. And that's one of my favorite features about our Simon Says Stamp Barely Beige ink. This ink takes on the color of whatever you're adding on top of it. So when you add your color down onto your image and then you blend it out or whatever, you're going to get these nice colored lines. So they're a little bit more contrasting than the coloring itself, but it's not too much where it's really harsh like a black line. So you get a really nice, beautiful finish with your coloring. So I really love our ink for that. So I'm coloring the kitties to look like my kitties, of course. One of which is Oscar. He is my shadow. He follows me literally everywhere. He's actually a really unique color combination. He's almost like a tiger cat. His mother was a tiger, but he has a cream and brown color scheme with these tiger stripes blended in between. It's really unique. So I colored him with those colors to try to match him up with that. And then for the second cat on my card, I'm coloring this one to look like my cat Maddie. She is such a sweetheart. She literally will sit in my office and let me do anything in my craft room, including using my heat gun. She doesn't even budge. So I colored her with black and brown to kind of match up with her color scheme. Now that I have all the coloring complete, I am going to use a Sharpie to fill in the details of their faces. Because of course we stamped with a no-line ink, their faces obviously aren't showing up yet. So I need to fill those in. I used a Sharpie because it is waterproof. So that way, if I want to add anything extra after I've drawn in the faces, I can, and I don't have to worry about the black bleeding. For the white, I am using a Signal White gel pen. I use that to add highlights to their eyes and nose and also fill in their whiskers. Well, except for Maddie. Maddie looks like she's sleeping. So for her, I actually just colored her eyes to look like she has them closed, but I did use that white gel pen to add in her whiskers. So now that I have the coloring complete, I cut those images out. I'm gonna set them aside while I work on my background. I've chosen some distress inks. I have the colors here, but I also have all of them linked below in the video description if you wanna know the exact colors that I used. I'm going to ink blend these colors through one of our Simon Says stamp stencils. This is the Tumbling Leaves stencil. And like I mentioned earlier, this is one of the products that I'm using today that is not a collaboration set and is not limited edition. This stencil is available at any time of year, so you can purchase this stencil at any time. You don't have to worry about it selling out. I'm coloring the stencil with these inks, and I'm working in a swoosh. I have, you can see the lightest colors kind of fading from the left up to the top right corner. So that's creating a really unique bit of movement on this card, and it's going to also create a beautiful background, very fall themed, with the rest of my images I'm going to add on top. So once I have the stenciling done, I'll remove that stencil, and I'm going to come back in with those same ink colors to ink blend over top of the stenciling, very, very lightly. I'm not heavily adding this ink down. I just want a little bit of color behind the leaves to soften them, and also to add more color to the background, because there's a lot of white here and I thought it was a little too harsh. So if I add this color down, it's going to soften everything up a little bit, and it's going to add just more color to my card in general. So I'll make sure I fade that color out past the leaves just to give everything a really nice shading. I did add some water splatters, which I let dry, so you can see those in the background here. And now I'm working on putting foam tape on the back side of my images. This tape actually happens to be from Scrapbook Adhesives. It's a really nice foam tape, and I'm going to go ahead and use that to put all of my images down onto my card. I'm going to arrange the images, trying to make sure to leave the top right corner open because that's where I plan on adding the greeting. When I'm arranging these images down onto the card, there are a few, like the pumpkins, that I haven't added down with foam tape, and rather I'm just gonna let rest on top of the card. And that's because I want some depth with this scene. I don't want everything the same level of dimension because that will not add as much depth to my scene. If I have some things in the background and other things more in the foreground, that's gonna give everything a more lifelike appearance. I also wanted to ground these images so they didn't look like they were floating in the middle of the card. So I'm using some Copic markers here. This is a warm gray 4 and a warm gray 2 marker. And I'm using those to just add a little bit of shading underneath the images, which will help ground them and make them look like they're actually standing on something. So the next step is to add the greeting. I could not decide which greeting I loved most out of this set. Ultimately, I think most fell in love with the fact that I love the I can't live without Mew sentiment, and that's because I can't live without my cats. So that one spoke to me, I think, the most, but all of the other sentiments are really good too. I'm prepping some dark chocolate cardstock from Simon Says Stamp with my rabbit hole powder tool, and I use Simon Says Stamp Clear Embossing Ink to stamp the image down. With some Simon Says Stamp white embossing powder, I'll sprinkle that over top of the stamped image, and then I took my heat tool and melted that embossing powder for a really nice bright white greeting on top of this dark cardstock, which is really nice and contrasting. I'm going to pop that sentiment up off of my card with two layers of foam tape because I did want the sentiment to be a little bit higher than the images in my scene. Again, we're going for some different levels of depth here, so I really liked how that paired up with the other layers. With a Simon Says Stamp glue stick, I'm going to stick a bit of adhesive on the backside of a pattern paper strip. I cut this into a really thin border. This is a nice basic striped pattern. It was a black and white striped pattern that I had in my stash. I don't know which pattern paper it came from, but black and white stripes are pretty common. So find any in your stash if you were trying to recreate this card. Find any in your stash that is kind of close. So along the top of my card with that strip, I'm also adding some twine. This is some Meyerowitz twine, and I just tied it in a bow underneath that paper strip. And with the Simon Says Stamp Hearts Party die set, I'm going to use that to cut a bunch of orange hearts that I cut from burnt orange cardstock from Simon. I glued one of the hearts to the bow, but then the rest of the hearts I'm going to scatter around my card. When I'm attaching these down, I am using some Simon Says Stamp Craft Tacky Glue. This is a thicker adhesive, and if I kind of blob it up a little bit underneath of my little die cuts, it actually will hold its shape, and so then the die cuts will be raised off of the surface of my card just a little bit. And so that adds another layer of dimension, just something very small, but it does make a good impact. So I'm just carefully laying those hearts into the glue, and then I'll let those dry. And once they are dry, look how cute this card is. It's a very sweet fall card with two of my adorable kitties, and I tried to make the person in the card look like me. And I think it's just a fun fall card. I would love to send this to one of my friends because I think this is a really cute and fun way to send something of me to them. And so a personal touch like that just really makes a big difference on a card. If you were going to make a card like this for somebody in your life, you could either make the cats look like your cats, or if you have a friend who does have cats, you could make the cats look like theirs. I think it's a really cute and fun way to make a personalized card for somebody. So don't forget this Simon Says Stamp and Picket Fence Studios Stamp Temper collaboration set called Sarcastic Kitties is not only super cute, but it is limited edition and only available while supplies last. So if you would love to get this set and be able to create some fun cards with it, don't wait too long. It is going to be very popular, I'm sure. You can find links to the set down below in the video description and also over on the Simon Says Stamp store. Thanks again for watching. I hope you were inspired today. I hope you enjoyed. And I can't wait to see you again very soon with more inspiration.